Hey, good morning to you. How y'all doing today? You pretty good? You alive? Are you kicking or not? Say. You ready to rock and roll? Amen. Come on. God bless you, Pastor. Good to see you, Pastor. You're moving on me, Pastor. I don't know which side you're going to be on. I know how you're doing now. Got another pastor. Pastor and Mrs. Krenz, our preacher and his wife for many, many years from Germany, been worshiping and leading churches for years. They're part of our body today as well, man. We're just blessed today. Looking forward to a picnic. But you got to get through the preaching first, okay? But it's going to be worth it, man. Getting past the preaching is some good fried chicken. Watermelon. I love watermelon, don't you? You can't have Memorial Day without watermelon. We got its own tent. We got a watermelon tent. You can walk over and get some watermelon in a watermelon tent. And then we got the best green beans. You might say, I don't like green beans. You wait till you eat these. These are basically bacon. You know what I'm saying? And some green beans floating around. Absolutely. And then you're going to have some potato salad, coleslaw, some of those rolls from Publix, you know, they like their rolls, but they should be donuts, you know what I'm saying? They're so soft and sweet. And all the trimmings, and we're going to give you some cake after all that. Amen? It's all free. You might say, well, I wasn't planning on doing that. Well, plan on it right now. Just plan on it. And we'll go out after church. Two big old long lines will be there, and you just jump in them, and they'll go. They fix the plate for you. And when you walk through, they'll just hand it to you. Amen. Try to say thank you. Can you do that or not? Come on. These people are working their tail off today. If it's your first time at fellowship, I know you're already in love with me. Now you're like, who is that guy? Who is that old guy with the bald head? But such a great smile. But anyway, I'm just talking. Anyway, let's get up and have church. Come on. I'm glad you're here today. Come on. Let's do it. Amen. Definitely a bigger crowd than the first service, but we had a pretty good crowd, but this is a good crowd. You know what? This gives me hope for our country. On Memorial Day weekend, when your attendance is usually down considerably, ours isn't. Ours isn't. Our attendance goes up on Memorial Day weekend. Now, it could be the chicken, but I don't think so. I don't think so. I think it's because we love America. We stand for our country. Okay? Amen. That's what we do. That's what we do. Amen. Am I thrilled with the direction of the country now? Absolutely not. At all. Okay? But I'm going to tell you, I got a message coming up. It's called Lest We Forget. How Not to Forget. That's what Memorial Day is all about. It's about not forgetting those who came before us, who laid down their lives so you and I could have freedom. And somehow we give up on our country because we don't agree with whoever's in charge of the politics up in Washington. Guys, I don't live in Washington. I live in Florida. I live in Inglewood, Florida. I live in the best state in the whole United States. And I live in the best area in the United States. Amen? Say. I'm just telling you, this is a great country. You might need to turn off your TV a little bit and just get outside and start to love people a little bit. You'll see we're a blessed nation. You hear me or not? Say. Churches all across the country today preaching God's word. We're free today. And we're going to, people all across the country is going to be out having picnics and dinners and meals and having fun. It's a great place we live. Amen? But this is important. This is the most important thing, I think, Sunday morning in America, right here, baby. So let's have church. Let's thank God we live in America really loud. Come on, here we go. Woo! Amen. Come on. Amen. Enjoy some worship. Jump on in and worship with us this morning. We're glad you're here watching online or you're on radio as well. Thank you so much. And if you ever get a chance, come on out and see us here at Fellowship. We appreciate it. Come on, let's have church. Here we go.
Are saved, found their way at the sound of your great name. Oh, condemned, feel no shame at the sound of your great name. Every fear sound of your great name. Oh, the enemy, yeah, he has to leave. Oh, at the sound of your great name, oh Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us, Son of God and man. Oh, you are high and lifted up, and all the world will praise your great. The sound of your great name, hungry souls are receiving their grace at the sound of your great name. Oh, the fatherless, every father rests at the sound. Your great name, oh, the sick are healed, and the dead are raised, oh, at the sound, yeah, at the sound of your great name, oh, Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us, Son.
Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to move right into another song. Glad you're here today. If it's your first time, again, I'm Pastor Gary. I see folks still coming in. I'm glad you're here, man. You get to be you here. You get to be you. What does that mean? You are you. The church will turn you in. It seems like we pull up and we act like somebody different. It's crazy. You are you. The mess you got is your mess. Struggles you have are yours. They're there. But it's okay, you can bring them in here, okay? Right around you is people that probably have some similar things going on. But God wants to love on you today. He wants to use people like me and others today to love on you, to let you know that you matter, you have value, and that He loves a snot out of you. You hear me or not? It might not feel like it. Maybe you're going through some mess. It might not feel like it, but God loves you. And that's, you're here today, and I want you to experience that today. We've got another great song Sherry's going to lead out on. It's called The Goodness of God. Let's sing to Him and praise Him this morning. Here we go.
I love You, Lord, for Your mercy never fails me. In all my days, I've been held in Your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life You have been faithful, and all my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. I love Your voice. You have led me through the fire. In the darkest nights, You are close like no other. I've known You as a father, and I've known You as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Oh yes, I have. 'Cause all my life You have been faithful, and all my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. I feel Your goodness running after me. 'Cause Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give You everything. 'Cause Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Can you feel it? Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. God, I give You everything. 'Cause Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. And all my life You
have been
faithful. Come on,
church. Tell Him this morning on Memorial Day weekend. Come on.
All my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. All my life You've been there. And all my been faithful, yes You have, Lord. And all my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness.
Wow, powerful. Wow, man. Woo, you in church. You in church now on Memorial Day weekend in Englewood, Florida, in case you don't know where you're at. Amen. But glad you're here, man. Wasn't that good? Come one more time. Let's thank the Lord. Man, I love it. We're having church. We're rolling now. Amen. Thank you. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you. Thank you for your love. Lord, thank you that you told your disciples that no greater love has a man than he lay down his life for his friends. And then you said, you're my friends. You're my friends. Lord, thank you for loving us like that. Lord, many of us, we know what it's like not to feel that way, not to feel loved, not to feel like we matter. But Lord, that's just not true. We know that's the enemy's lie. You love us. God, you so love us that you gave your one and only Son, Jesus, so that we could have everlasting life by simply putting our faith in you, Jesus. Lord, thank you for that kind of kindness to us, to love us like that. Lord, I pray for anybody here today, watching online or on the radio or right here in this big room. Lord, I pray none will leave lost. None. None of us, Lord. You say you're not willing any should perish, but all should come to repentance. Lord, I pray that for everyone here today. Lord, we get confused. We get crazy. Lord, I pray today we'll get it right. We'll get it right that you, Jesus Christ, you're the way, the truth, and the life, that no man can come to God but by you. Lord, it's not us or the church or our good works. It's you. It's you. Would you help us today? Lord, please touch every heart here today. May it be so clear that they know when they die they're going to go to heaven. Their faith is in you. Cause it to happen, Lord. It's not going to happen unless you help them. Would you help us today, Lord? We fall at your feet flat. We don't want to have church without you. Be in our midst, we pray. Help us, we pray. We give you praise today in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Be seated. Thank you so much. Mr. Alexander Christie, how you doing, buddy?
Great. How are you?
I heard we're having a picnic.
We are.
How's it going?
Beautifully.
Do we have the chicken?
No.
Where's the chicken?
Publix.
When you get a chicken?
Soon.
Go.
Well, good morning, everybody. How y'all doing this morning? Thank you for being here. We should do fried chicken more often. There's a beautiful crowd. Amen, right? Hard to beat it. Well, today, if today's your first time here, welcome to Fellowship Church. Thank you for being here this morning. If you don't mind filling out that guest registry that's right there in your worship guide that you got when you came in the door this morning, or you can go out to our Welcome Center after the service and fill out the same basic info. We promise not to bother you. We just want to send you a note of thanks for being here this week and then a postcard. Just whenever a big event is going on here at the church, we just want to keep you in the loop a little bit. And otherwise, we promise not to harass you or anything like that or ask you for stuff all the time. And good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in online this morning. Do us a favor. Send us a Facebook message or an email. We'll do the same thing for you. And as Pastor alluded to so gently a moment ago, we are having fried chicken in about an hour, right? We're thinking, you know, somewhere around noonish. Oh, he made a face, so maybe quarter after, 20 after. We're going to... Okay. And we'd love for you to come on out right afterward. Please come, just walk on over to those picnic tables. We have some tables closer to the side of the building, so it's a little bit easier if you're mobility impaired. And we are just, you know, we just really want everyone to come on out. We're looking forward for folks. If you're at home right now watching and you haven't left the house and you're local, come on out around noon today, and we're going to give you a beautiful free luncheon with all the sides, all the fixings, everything you could possibly want. But most importantly, that Publix fried chicken will be out there. And it's just fantastic. It'll be great. They're cooking it up fresh for us this morning. So please come on out this morning. And we got lots of Bible studies going on here at Fellowship Church. If you haven't plugged into one yet, please check them out. They're right there in your worship guide. And give us a call at the office if you have any questions about any of them. We have Friend to Friend every single Tuesday here at Fellowship Church. A great chance for you to make some new friends, get into God's Word with other believers, and play some board games also. Just have a great time. That's every Tuesday right here at Fellowship Church. And grief shares every Wednesday. If you or anyone you know has suffered the profound loss of losing a loved one, we just can't encourage you enough to come on out on a Wednesday and find some healing here at Fellowship Church through this great group of people that come together, love the Lord, and they're finding value. They're finding understanding that they're not crazy for feeling the way they're feeling, and then that they can find a new meaning through the Lord, through with this group's help. So come on out on a Wednesday. We'd love to have you. And Celebrate Recovery meets here every single Wednesday at 6 o'clock. They serve a beautiful meal out there in the foyer, which is right when Grief Share ends at 6. Everything starts out there in the foyer with a great meal before they come in here at 6:30. And this week is a special week. They're going to have a great concert coming up. If you all remember Mr. Mike Heppner, he's going to be back. He's a pianist that plays when Miss Karen's out of town, or he steps in once in a while and does a great solo with Pastor Gary. He's coming back for this coming up Wednesday, and they have a special guest drummer coming out who used to be the drummer for Stevie Wonder. So it's going to be a really great night. I can't encourage you enough to come on out on Wednesday. Come for the meal, stay for the concert, and just really have a great Wednesday here with us at Fellowship Church. And this is a Friday night, done right. Fun night now, yeah, right. That's on Tuesdays, excuse me. Yeah, DeFi. And at the beach on the 30th, the last Tuesday of the month coming up, if you know anybody in that middle school, high school age, on this coming up Tuesday, right? It's going to be at the beach, pavilion number 2, by the basketball courts to the left of the big bathroom pavilion. And just, you know, and parents, guardians, come on out with those middle school, high school age kids. Stay with them. Get to know other parents while the kids play. And they learn more about their value and how to fight against the temptations of smoking and drinking and premarital sex and all of these different things that everyone struggles with at those tough ages. So this is a great organization, and they're going to be doing that this Tuesday, all for free at the beach. Men's prayer breakfast is not. It is not going to be this Saturday. Instead, we're going to be meeting on the 17th at Good Times over at Merchants Crossing. We'll have a sign-up sheet for you next week, guys, so please keep that in mind for that 17th morning for a great breakfast. All for free, by the way. And one step at a time, we're still collecting some shoes this week and next week. They take these sneakers, they clean them up, and then they donate them to people that are in need. So if you have old shoes, old sneakers around, please bring them in. And there's a big blue bucket out there. We already filled it up once, so we can do it again. And this is our town. Thank you so much for wearing the shirts, putting the bumper stickers on your cars, and getting the word out about Fellowship Church. We can't thank you enough for doing that. If you would consider continuing doing that, or if you haven't done it yet, grab a shirt or put something on your car today. It directs people here to Fellowship Church. And as always, we thank you so much for giving at Fellowship Church. Our give2fc.com, super easy way to give online. I know we had a hiccup last week. We're dealing with some legality, not that's a wrong word, but some weirdness with the website. We have to get this licensing cleared up with that one specific website. But if you were to go to fcenglewood.com, you can just log in right through that Give to Fellowship, and it'll take you right there, and it all works just like it always did. Super easy way to give online. One-time, weekly, monthly gift. We're so grateful for all your gifts, and we thank you so much for your giving on with that P.O. Box 121 as well. All you folks up north that are watching, we've already been receiving so many of your notes. We thank you so much for staying in touch with us. And we had hospitality, so please come for a second hospitality over on the other side of the lakes and have some fried chicken with us in just a little bit. We love and appreciate you and hope you have a great day. God bless you all.
I do have a question, though. Are you feeling good about the chicken coming?
I feel great, but they've never let us down.
They've never let us down.
Well, everyone, when you hear Publix, you hear the tagline. Which is? Shopping is a pleasure.
Oh, good. Good. Well, anyway, I just want you to call them, make sure.
I called yesterday.
Okay.
And last Tuesday.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I won't worry. Do we have watermelons already?
What? Oh, yeah. Watermelons are here, and they're cold.
Then we're good. 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 No, it's going to be great. Hope you'll eat with us. I know we're terrible, aren't we? If you're not eating with us, you must feel really bad. But anyway, no, come on and have a good lunch with us. Well, Memorial Day, we honor those who gave their life for our country. And many of them, probably most of them, were young. And it goes a long ways back, you know. It goes back to before we were a nation, you know, before 1776. There were people fighting and trying to stand for our freedoms. And, you know, people came from across the seas to want to have religious freedom. They won't tell you that much. That's why they came. They want to be able to raise their children. They want to be able to preach God's word without, you know, what the king had to tell them to do. And so they fought for it, and they came here and did that. And then, of course, with the Civil War, and then wars down through the ages. Well, this is a song. This song's probably been around. I'm guessing it's probably close to 100 years old. I'm guessing. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. I can't imagine, but that's also from the Bible. If he knows the sparrow and he takes care of the little bird, hello, how much better are you than birds, the Bible says. I can only imagine many down through the ages probably even thought of that as they're going to battle, as they're in battle, they're in hard times, when it's just up against the wall, and knowing that God, your eyes on the sparrow, you're watching me in this dangerous situation. You know, so it just gives this song a little new meaning. It's a very old song. Got the piano going to play the music with Miss Karen, and the two of them are going to sing this old hymn called His Eye is on the Sparrow. Let's thank the Lord for him this morning. Would you? Come on. Amen. Appreciate it.
Should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? And why should my heart feel lonely and long for help? When Jesus is my portion, my constant friend is He. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know watches me. So I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I am free. Yeah. His eye is on the sparrow.
Your heart be troubled. His tender word I hear, and resting on His goodness, oh, I'll lose all my doubts and though by the path He leadeth, oh, one step I may see, His eye is on the sparrow, and I know on
Wow. That's an old song. Well done. Wow. What a blessing. Come on. Praise the Lord. Yeah. I hit a nerve. Amen. Let's jump up on up. Jump on up one more time. Help me now. Get on up. Get on. If you can. If you can. If you can. If you can't, try. Try. Anyway. Wow. What a blessing. Our offering is coming up in just a bit. You're at a little bit of a different kind of church. I think you probably already figured that out. We're a debt-free ministry. What does that mean? We don't borrow money. Ain't borrowing money. Doesn't happen. Okay? We trust the Lord. We believe the Lord. But we don't think when you give money, it's like magic time. You give and you're going to get it doubled. We don't teach any of that mess, okay? Okay? We believe we give because we want to, because God's been good to us. Amen? And we try to do it with a cheerful attitude. That's what we do here. So if you want to do that today, we'd invite you to help us. But here's the interesting thing. We got a brand new wing or facility we're going to build right out of here to our right. And as you walk today, going down towards the picnic area, there's three crosses. We have communion right in front of that, behind it, will be this facility. And it's for children, but it's for Bible studies, it's a prayer garden, and it's probably also going to have a water feature, Lord willing, with it as well. It'll be open to the community. People can come in, even when we're not here, be a place they can pray, they can contemplate, they can reflect. Maybe they can lay it down for the Lord. Amen. And we got a beautiful campus. We already have people doing that. But this is exciting. And so far, we've been, you know, just plugging along here. Debt-free means you got to have money, right? So right now, we're at about $900, I believe, and $30,000 raised. Amen. Come on. Praise the Lord. It's going now. We're rolling now. We're rolling. We're not going to start right away. Not going to start right away on this project. Going to keep raising the funds. Might be 2 million, 2.5, 3. I'm just not sure because times are crazy right now. How about we stay steady and see what happens? Amen? So if you want to help us, all the offering today goes to that. All the offering today goes to this. All the offering today goes to this. Memorial Day weekend, all of it goes to this. Amen? So that's coming up. Before that, a great song on America. It's called America the Beautiful. Are y'all ready to sing a great song about your country? Are you ready? Say, are you ready? Amen. Okay, Mr. Joel Herring's going to lead us out, and he's going to play that fancy blue guitar. And we're going to hear America the Beautiful and just a beautiful rendition. And let's help him do it. Here we go. Thank you, Lord, for America.
Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, God shed His grace on thee and crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, for heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than self their kind. sage retreat that sees beyond the years. Thy alabaster sees gleam, undimmed by human tears. America, America, God shed His grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. America, America, God shed His grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Wow. Come on, come on, one more time. Thank God we live in America. Let's go, come on. Amen. Praise the Lord. Great job, band, today. We appreciate you. Man, that was good stuff, wasn't it? I mean, I'm telling you, I could just sort of mesmerize a little bit just singing a song like that, thinking it through. Man, that's my message is coming on the heels of this. A little series for 2 weeks called Lest We Forget, Lest We Forget, Lest We Forget. Today, how not to forget, how not to forget. That's what Memorial Day is about, remembering, remembering. Let's talk about it today in just a minute from the Bible. But right now, thank you for giving to the Lord's work. It's going to a beautiful kid's wing. I know you can't see it. We've got renditions of it and all that kind of mess, but we couldn't see this either, this place. Amen. It's crazy. It's crazy what God's been doing here at Fellowship Church. Amen. And so we expect that we'll do that as well. If it gets hard, it'll get hard. We'll just deal with it. Amen. Jeff, come on and pray for us, buddy. God bless you. Had a great meeting with you this week in my office. Man, and I already loved this guy, but fell in love with him more because of his heart for the Lord. And I appreciate you. And it was good. And you helped me. You helped me. Yeah, I don't just help people. People help me because I need help too, man. And so, but thank you, buddy boy. And we appreciate you giving. Would you lead us in prayer? Come on. Go give. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we just, again, we're so blessed to be here in Florida, in this great state.
Look at us.
With this great pastor.
Help us.
And just with this great congregation.
Amen.
But on this special Memorial Day, we also just, our blessings are even like quadrupled we're just so blessed to live in America.
We are.
And we thank you for that, Lord. We thank you for putting us here.
Amen.
Guide us. Help us to help this country get back on the path it should be.
Should.
Thank you for this offering. We ask that you bless it. Help us to use it wisely. And know that we offer all this to you in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen, baby. Thank you, man. Appreciate you, man. Y'all be seated. Thank you very much. God bless you, man. Y'all be seated. Hey, a special thanks to you that are watching online right now. Would you write us a little note? I know I say that every week, but I read every one of them. Would you write us a little note online? If it's Facebook, that's okay. And just let us know where you're listening and how you're doing. Maybe a word of encouragement. Maybe that song, America the Beautiful, blessed you. Why don't you tell us about it? A little bit of how the music touched you today. Amen. But also, thank you for giving. You're a huge, huge help to us, you that give on the online ministry. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's thank the Lord for Miss Karen. Everybody serving us today. Amen. Well, here we go. Let's go to the Word this morning. Let's get in the Word. We had a great time of worship. I was blessed this week. I'm blessed all the time, to be honest with you, where I live. When I go around town, it's not like, you know, I mean, I'm just me. I get people waving at me. How you doing, Pastor? People will stop me and ask me to pray for them. That's where we live. This is our town. I call it my town. This is my town. It is. I'd encourage you to make it your town. If you live here, you're not where you were. Maybe that complaining about this town will stop if you realize you live here now. You hear me or not, say. And it'll just change things. But I'm just so blessed. I'm blessed to have the friends I have in law enforcement throughout our community. And I'm blessed to be invited to have a big, to partake in the big awards banquet the other night down on Peace River, right down at the big event center, probably 500 people. And they call on me. And that's where I live. This is fantastic. And God's blessed me. And so I was able to be there the other night with all the police officers, firefighters, first responders, public safety. And it was beautiful. Yeah, let's thank the Lord for them. Right here, Fellowship Church stands behind you. And that's what I told them. A lot of them came up to me and said, I listened to you on the radio. Or we had a fallen officer I did the service for. And it was a horrible situation. I hated every minute of that. But we did it. We were there with them. And so a lot of them came up and spoke to me and had some telling me they listened to me on the radio. And they're putting a face now with the crazy voice and all that kind of stuff. But I was blessed to speak to them for a few minutes, not long, and to pray. And I told them that the faith community in Charlotte County, that we're with them, that we love them, that we believe in them, that we appreciate them. And so on your behalf and others, we spoke like that the other night. And every table had a flower. This flower was on every table. These flowers you see, every table, 60-plus tables had these flowers on them, the head tables, the everything like that. And these were made by my wife and her mother. Every one of these for all the first responding tables down there. Amen. We appreciate you, Kim and Miss Jenny. Appreciate you doing that. And it was beautiful. And you know what? I told them we did it. But I told them we did it because we love them and because they matter. Amen. So we say the same for you today. As you see these up here, just know that you matter. If you've served our country and whether you have or not, you matter. You hear me or not? But especially if you've served in the armed services and if you've lost a loved one who served, we grieve with you. And we're just glad here to honor you today. Amen. Let's talk about it a little bit. Let's an unusual message. It's going to be unusual. Probably make some of you mad. Are you ready to get mad? Here we go. Time with Uncle Gary. Time to get mad. Don't think you'll get mad if you'll listen. The message is called Lest We Forget. Today is how not to forget, how not to forget, how not to forget. Roll, Rog, let's go. We'll use this big screen, have the scriptures on it, some statements of mine, etc. The phrase, lest we forget or never forget, you see that on monuments in our country, never forget, never forget. Guess where it came from? It came from the Bible. Most good things in America came from the Bible. Yeah, thank the Lord. Most good things came from God's Word. You don't believe in God, do you? It's funny how we don't want to believe in God when we got the cake and we're eating it. You know what I'm saying? But somebody had to lay the groundwork. Somebody had to do what was done, and it was people who believed in Jesus Christ. You cannot go to Washington, D.C. It's like dropping from another planet. You go to Washington, crazy people in Washington, but all around them, Scripture, Scripture. Like these people are blind. You hear me or not? Say. And this is our country. This is who we are. We've forgotten who we are. And it's a shame, and it's a disgrace, and it's on the church, too. And we're going to talk about it just for a little bit. All right? Y'all already mad at me? Come on. I thrive on that. Come on. No, I really don't. Let's go. Lest we forget. It's been commonly used to remember the soldiers. Don't forget the soldiers who bled and died to preserve this nation's freedom. You'll see that a lot, lest we forget or never forget. The Bible says, read this out loud with me if you don't mind. Only take heed to yourself and keep your soul diligently. Say it out loud, lest you forget the things which your eyes have seen unless they depart from your heart all the days of your life. Last part, but teach them to your sons and to your sons' sons. So this is huge, guys. Memorial Day is a big deal in America. It's a big thing to remember. But I want you to remember, this goes way back before some congressman or senator made it a holiday. Memorial Day was happening way back when. It was happening in the 1700s when people were fighting for freedom in this land, and they were perishing, and they were being buried, and most congregations, small congregations, had people right out of their congregations, family members who were giving their life for freedom. It was happening all around. It continued to happen. And then into the Civil War, it continued to happen. It happened in World War I and World War II. But back in the day, it was churches. It was churches who would gather around those families who had lost loved ones. It was church people. It was churches who would, and family members who would take a little wreath, handmade, and take it and put on a grave. They didn't have florists. They didn't have fancy anything. All they had was heart. And they remembered those who gave their life for this country. And it was the church who stood by these people. That's where Memorial Day came from. Are y'all hearing me or not? But it wasn't the church's idea. It was God's idea. God's idea. There's certain things you don't forget. Say that out loud. There's certain things you don't what? You don't forget. And so let's talk about it today. How do I not forget, man? We forget all the time. We're horrible. You hear me or not? It's crazy. How can I be better at this? There you see the Pearl Harbor Memorial. Never forget. And of course, we remember this one very, very, very much. Never forget what? 9/11. It came from the scriptures. We're not to forget these kind of things that happen in our country and in our life. But I'm going to tell you something. I met a man a few years ago. I was up in Carolina. Matter of fact, you know right where this is at. Seven Lakes. You probably have lots of customers and clients right there. I was at that McDonald's at 7. I'm sure you've been through that McDonald's. I've been there through a bunch of times. Get me some ice cream cones is what I do. I'm going to tell you that right now. It's hot. But I had a little cabin up there in Jackson Springs I'd been working on years ago. Charlie, are you here today, Charles? Oh, no. Charles, is this a true story I'm about to tell? All right. I was at Seven Lakes with Charles. Charles travels with me some. He's got 8 children, so he's always glad to get out of town. So anyway, Charles and I, we doing what we do. We ain't bothering nobody. We coming in. We going to get us some breakfast, a sandwich or something. I think it was breakfast. And there's a big group of people in there. I'm country folk. These folks, a lot of them country folk. Some of them ain't country folk. Some of them have moved down from the north. That's all right. We love northern people. We just don't like northern people coming down here and making us what you running from. But that's okay. And so this fella, he was an older man, pretty well healed by the way he looked, by the way he was speaking. Imagine he probably had $1 million plus home, I'm just thinking. Probably had a retirement and money out to Gazoo. Had moved down to one of the nicest places on the planet, Pinehurst, North Carolina. All right. So, but he was griping, complaining, moaning about pretty much where he had moved to, the conservative values, the beliefs down here. This is in Carolina. And then he said this. It's hard to be an American. Did I look like that, Charles? Charles thought a fight was going to break out. Charles, I can't remember what I said to him, but I know I said something. I didn't cuss, right? Thank you, Lord. I didn't put my hands on him, did I? Nope. But I'm sure I said something, and I challenged him a little bit on that. Charles was way worse than I am. I mean, what are you talking about? You're so blessed. You have everything. You have everything. You moved to one of the nicest places on the planet just because we don't believe. You moved down to here where we live, and just because we don't believe what you do, you're going to be publicly running your mouth, and it's, what are you doing? It's crazy. You forgot where you came from. This is America. You're blessed, man. Hard to be an American. Are you kidding me? I didn't talk like that, though. And so we had our little talk. It was fine. We left. But as we're leaving, here's Charlie. Oh, here's Charlie. Charlie's funny. Charlie's doing this. It's hard to be an American where at least I know I'm free. Let's thank the Lord for Charles. True story. Listen, though. Here's the problem, though. Here's the problem, guys. And you know, if that offended you, get over it, grow up, let's go, okay? The offending's really coming now. I mean, that was nothing. It used to be years ago I'd hear that once in a blue moon. And since I'm conservative, I would usually hear it from a liberal. And I don't hear it much, but I'd hear it every once in a while. But you know what? I'm meeting people all the time now who are saying, and feeling that way right now, it's hard to be an American. And it's not liberals anymore, it's conservatives. It's people who are conservative like I do and have conservative values, and they're saying it's hard to be an American. I want to say the same thing I said to him. You need to shut up. You need to quit thinking like that. It's hard to be an American. It's hard to have freedom. It's hard to live in Florida. It's hard to have public worship. No one's coming in here. It's hard. It's hard to have a job and go. You can go get one. It's really hard, ain't it? Now, it might be hard in Ethiopia or Ukraine or some places that are in China. But God help us as Christians and believers, conservative or liberal, that we say such a thing. Are y'all hearing me today? It is not hard to be an American. All right? And if that ruffled your feathers, good. That's why you came to church. Y'all hear me or not? Hey, look, I'm just like you. If you're a conservative, I am. That's the way it is. I believe God's word. I believe it when I read it. I believe life begins at conception. I believe male, female, okay? Because that's what the Bible says. I believe in creation. That's what I believe, because that's what the Bible says. Okay? That doesn't mean I'm a hater. I don't hate people that believe different than me. But what I don't like is whatever side you own to say, it's hard to be an American. It'd be hard to be an American. I've got an event I'm going to be at this summer with the 13 that were killed leaving Afghanistan. They're doing a memorial for them. I'll be there. It would be hard to be their parents. Now that's hard, to have lost a loved one in battle and war, something I don't know anything about. But hard to be an American? Have I lost y'all today or not? Are we making sense or not? Now, how can I never forget? How can I never forget? I don't want to just come and rant and rave on Memorial Day. He rant and raved and gave us chicken. You bought the chicken. It's free, but it's your money. Amen. No. Let's learn. This week is how I never forget. Next weekend is if we forget. God help us, because this is what's going to happen if we forget. What happens when we forget? It'll be a hard message next Sunday morning. You'll see it. Next Sunday morning. I've already got it worked on. It's pretty well done. But today is how I don't forget. How about we start right there? Yes or no? Amen. Let's look at the scripture again. How do I not forget? My blessings, Lord. How can I have so much stuff and my life is good and it seems like it's crap? How don't want to live like that. Help me, Lord. What can I do? Take heed to yourself. You're going to have to work on you. And you keep your soul diligently down deep in your gut. What you're thinking, what you're saying, what you're imagining, it's going to get down inside of you. You better watch. You better watch it. And guard your heart and guard yourself. Why? Lest you what? Forget the things your eyes have seen. How many with an uplifted hand would say, I've seen some wonderful things in America? Right? Say, wow. Lest your eyes forget the things which you have seen. Lest your heart and your eyes, they depart all the days of your life if you're not careful. But teach them to your sons and your sons' sons. So how can I not forget? Simple message from here on forward. It's not hard from here on. This is easy. Psalm 103. Here we go. Psalm 103. Number one, I got to take heed to myself. Number two, I got to keep my soul diligently. How do I do that? Psalm 103. Just simple. You might say, Pastor, why did you pick a passage like this today on America? It's not just America, guys. This is before America. God was before America. God was in these people's hearts across the seas before they came to America. They wanted to come here because of him. We need to go back further than America. If we don't want to forget, we need to go back a little bit further. And that's what Psalm 103 says. How do I not forget? Number one, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. How do I not forget my blessings? How do I not forget that I'm an American? How do I not forget that I have the cat by the tail? I've got life, you know, off the chain, man. I am blessed. How do I not forget? Number one, say it with me out loud. Out loud. I will bless the Lord. Now you're half with me. Come on, let's get on the bus. Here we go. I will bless the Lord. How do you think that might help your attitude? Say, my life's crappy. Yeah, it's hard to be an American. Try doing that when you're blessing the Lord, thanking the Lord, praising the Lord. You've been good to me, God. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your blessings on me. Amen. How many remember when you didn't have an inside bathroom to go to? Let me see some hands. There's still people like that. Amen. How many remember what it was like to live from paycheck to paycheck and you still didn't have enough? You are blessed. I'm blessed. How many remember what it was to walk? You had to walk because you didn't have a car. You just made it. You are blessed. You hear me or not? I will bless the Lord. That's number one. Let's keep going. Number two. Now you can do this without me. I don't have to be at home with you to do this. Psalm 103. Look at verse 2. Wow, he says it again because we're hard-headed. Oh, and by the way, I want to say something. The guy I jumped on a little bit at the place in Seven Lakes, I'm no better than him. I found myself doing the same thing. Different time. I want to say that because we are all prone to do this. You understand? This ain't a message. It's a message about us, me, we. So what can I do, Lord? Help me. You told me, lest I forget, I got to do something. Number two, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. So what's the next one? Say it out loud with me. I will not forget his benefits. Can you say, I don't do this all the time, but I'm going to say I'm thankful for. I want you to think about something you're thankful for. I want you to think about it. I'm going to say I'm thankful for, and I want you, after I say the word for, you just to holler out what you're thankful for. You ready? On the count of three. Let's just try to practice right quick. Count of three. I'm thankful for, and then, okay, here we go. Ready? One, two, three. I'm thankful for my family. Do you think we might be better people if we wouldn't forget his benefits? turn off the news, go help a neighbor, kiss your wife, pet the dog, do something. Come on. Amen. Number three, help us, Lord, help us, Lord. Verse 3, who forgives all my sin and heals all my diseases. Yeah, praise the Lord. Hey, come on. Come on. So, God forgives. How many sinners I got that had some forgiveness before in your life? Isn't it funny how we get high and mighty? It's hard to be an American. I don't like the way things are going in the country. Hey, I don't either. What's that got to do with anything? It takes people who love God and country more than themselves, their country love. That's what the song said. Amen? That's what makes America beautiful. So remember, God forgives. But not only that, God heals. God heals. God does heal. You know, but here's the thing. I got bad news. You're going to die one day. And people are trying to make a lot of money off of you in the church. It's a lie and it's wrong. But God does heal. How many just remember having a bad flu or something like that you thought was going to kill you within the last year, and you are doing good now? Can I see some man? Look at me. Look at me. He heals us all the time. He heals us. How many was in a bad automobile accident you didn't think you were going to make? Anybody like that in this room? Look at you. Look at you. Look at you. Look at you. God's blessed you. Amen. Yes or no? How many in the hospital you didn't think you were getting out? Any hands? Let me see something. In the hospital, you didn't think you're out. Yay! She, yay! Don't forget his benefits. Don't forget he forgives you of your sin, your nasty sin. Oh, I got nasty sin. Oh, I got some nasty sin. I still sin. And God is a good God to Gary. I'll tell you that right now. He forgives me and he loves me. He puts up with my crap. You hear me or not? Say. Good word today. Who redeems my life from destruction. Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercy. God saved, say it with me. God saved me from hell. I'm loud today, ain't I? How am I supposed to say it? God saved me from hell. How many had a hellacious life, some hell in your life, and God delivered you from that as well? Can I see some hands? He saved me from that hell in my life. Wow. But it's hard to be an American. We are crazy people. This will work, man. He saved me from a devil's hell. You can tell the devil, you can cuss at the devil. Or even somebody tells you go to hell, you can say, hell no. I've done it before. I've done it several times. Yeah. They think they got you. You go to hell, and you go, hell no. I can't go. I can't go. I can't go. Because my name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. Right there, baby. Woo! Ha! So, we're just talking about how to help yourself. Amen? And guys, I'm the worst sometimes. Don't think, oh, he's just a cheerleader in life all the time. I get down. I get in a funk. I get going inward. I get thinking too much. And it screws me up. And if it does that to me, I got a feeling there's probably some in here that does that to you as well sometimes. So this is good for our heart today. Amen? He also, look at this. God has sent with me. God blessed me with what? He loved me, gave his son for me. You know what the word mercy means? Most people don't know it. It means price paid. So he loved me and he paid the price for my sin. And he's continuing to love me and he's continued to show mercy on my life. What a great God we have. Amen. So Memorial Day to me, it's about our country, but it's more than our country. It's about Jesus Christ. who we love and who we serve. We're almost done. Who satisfies my mouth with good things so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. Say that with me. God is good to me. Wonder how that would change your attitude when your blood pressure is about to pop out of your head when you're watching the latest thing out of Washington. We're not getting a pass, guys. We're followers of Jesus Christ. God is good to me. Doesn't mean I don't need to stand. It doesn't mean I don't need to vote. It doesn't mean I don't need to help organize and do what I can do to make change. Doesn't mean any of that, but you cannot sacrifice your blessing the Lord. You can't sacrifice that attitude, that good attitude about our country. You hear me or not? God's good to you. How many just lately, God's just been good to you? Can I see some hands? God's just been good to you. Just lately. Yeah. And when I say that, you think of something that happened. Just lately. Don't forget. Tell your kids about it. Look what happened. Talk to them. Tell them about your past. Oh, man. Like my son years ago, he wanted to give a testimony. I've told you this before. In Awana, back at the old church that we were at before. It was beautiful. And they said, it's your turn to give your testimony next week. And Mitchell came to me and he said, Daddy, I want to give, they got me giving my testimony, but I don't have no testimony. I want to give them your testimony. So you know what I told him? And they ain't but 7-year-olds in that class. I said, you go in there and you look at them and go, Jesus saved me from a devil's hell. And that's what he did. That is our testimony. Yes or no, amen. Come on, we all have a testimony, man. Come on. So, God is good to me. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. What does that mean? Say it with me. God always does right. He always does right. Remember that when you blame him. I do. I blamed him. Why'd you let this happen to me? I can't believe you let this happen to me. I've done it. I'm not in my right mind when I do that. God has always done right in my life. God has been the one faithful and really only faithful person or persons in my life has been God himself. Everybody else I know is a sinner. But God is so true to me and he's so good to me. Amen? You hear me or not? Well, he ain't that way to me. Maybe you need to back up and start thinking different. Amen. Wow, would you read the list with me? Everybody on board now. Are we all here? Yes or no? All on board. Chicken's coming. Hang on. Here we go. Say it with me at the top. How do I not forget? How can I stop being in this bad attitude, this funk I got myself in? How can I stop feeling like our country's no good and things like that? That's not true. Here's how you do it. Say it with me. I will bless the Lord. I will not forget his benefits. God forgives and heals. God saved me from hell. God bless me with love and mercy. God is good to me, and God always does right. Let's thank him for that right there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Boom. Woo! Now, you thought we were done. We're close. Come on. Here we go. I don't have any more points, but I cannot leave these scriptures out. Psalm 103. Are you kidding me? Let me just read them. You watch. As far as the east is from the west, so far has God removed our sins from us. What? Like a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those that respects him, that fears him, that honors him, that remembers him. For he knows our frame. He knows us. He knows how weak we are. He knows we came from where? Dust. As a man, his days are as grass. As a flower of the field, so he flourishes. For the wind passes over it, and it is gone. And the place thereof shall know it no more. The things we put emphasis on in life, it's gone. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those that fear Him, that remember Him, that don't forget Him, that honor Him, that respect Him. Where am I at? I'm lost. Hang on. And His righteousness, I'm just like you, I'm crazy, okay, here we go. And His righteousness is unto His what? Children's children. Don't ever give up hope on your kids. I hate to tell you this, you might could make a big difference in your kid's life if your attitude changed. And you started doing what we put on the screen today and start doing this stuff, instead of telling the kids, maybe they see you. It's hard to be an American. To such as keep His covenant. Say it out loud with me. This is the message. And to those that remember His commandments to do them. Amen. So, it's not hard to be an American when we don't forget. Let's thank the Lord for His word. We're done. Amen. Boom. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on. Let's stand on up. Now, don't leave and act like we got to go to the restaurant. We know you ain't. Here we go. Let's end reverently. I know a couple are going to serve. I get that. But if you can hang in here with me, let's do that. Amen. Just heads bowed. Please. Man, after I get up here and rant and rave like I do, it takes a minute or two for us to calm down. And just let the Lord help us in our life for just a moment. Okay? Let's pray together. Lord, thank You for Your word. Lord, I'd go crazy without Your word. I'm already sort of crazy, you know, Lord. But it's moments like these today that I can open up Your word. I can see the way back home to bless Your name. To not forget how good You've been to me, how good You've been to us as a country. Lord, please help my own mind personally. Give me eyes, Lord, that can see the good You've done in my life. Help me stand against the wiles of the devil, the wicked one, who wants me to blame You, God, after how good You've been to me. Lord, I pray this message will find good ground in every heart today, especially mine, in Jesus' name. And guys, with heads bowed, I would be a bum of a pastor. That's the way I feel. If I didn't give you a chance, the opportunity to put your faith in Christ. Today's the only day you've got, period. We don't know we have it tomorrow. Yesterday's gone. But in a crowd this size, are you kidding me? There's probably many today, if you died, you don't know you'd go to heaven. But the Bible says God loves you to pieces. He gave His Son for you, Jesus. He died on a cross. He rose from the dead so you could be saved. And He loves you. He's not against you. He's actually for you. Matter of fact, the Bible says Jesus Himself is right now at the right hand of God the Father, praying for you, making intercession for you. Isn't that crazy? But guys, we've got it screwed up. What do I mean by that? If you're here today and you think going to church will get you to heaven, that's screwed up. That's not right. Or maybe you think being a good person or doing good will get you there. It won't. You can only be saved by putting your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. God had one son. His name was Jesus. And it might sound like, well, that's narrow-minded. Well, it is a narrow way. It is narrow. He did it. Why shouldn't he tell you if he did it and him tell you the truth? He said, if you'll believe in me today, this truth will set you free. Can I lead you in a prayer today where you put your faith in Christ? You mean it can be done by a prayer? Well, the Bible says if you confess with your mouth Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. So yes, yes. But it can't be from a heart that's insincere. That's why it says you've got to believe in your heart, down in your gut, that God loves you and gave his son for you. Can I lead you in a prayer now to do that? Would you say no to good works and going to church is going to get me there and giving money is going to make it happen? Would you say no to all that and yes to Jesus? Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, right where you are. Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I've done plenty wrong. I ask you to forgive me, Lord. And Jesus, I want you to know that I believe in you. I believe you're God's only son. I believe you died on the cross and you rose from the dead. And I believe that you love me. I don't understand it all. I don't. But this is me, Lord. And I mean it. And I put my faith in you. Would you save me today, Lord, on Memorial Day weekend 2023? Today? I don't want to leave lost. In Jesus' name. With heads bowed, how many would raise a hand and say, Pastor Gary, I got that clear as crystal. I understood it. I did it. I meant it. Can I see your hand if you said that prayer today? And you meant that. I'm not playing. I'm not playing games. It was the truth, man. I love that. I love your hands. Those are the prettiest hands I see every week. Them hands flying up like that. Lord, bless us, we pray. Bless those that put their faith in you today. Bless those that returned to you today in their faith. Bless most in this room, Lord, today who are like me. They heard a message like this and they realized, wow, man, I got some work to do. I got some work to do. Bless us all, we pray, Lord. We give you credit. And Lord, I pray for this meal that's going to follow. Would you bless the food and the folks that served? Would you help us that are going to go partake to smile at those that are serving us and tell them we appreciate them? Thank you, Lord, that we live in this country, a country where we can go have free fried chicken. That is crazy. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you sing this song with me? Here we go. Here we go. God. Here we go. God bless America. Come on. Land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains, come on, to the prairies, to the oceans, that's us, white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. Yeah! Go get some chicken. Come on. I'm early. You might get there before it's ready. Isn't that crazy? I never end early unless there's food. Come on. Y'all be good. I'm here.